close to you. Never let me go. I lay it all down again to hear you say that I'm a friend. You are my desire. No one else will. In the mighty name of our Lord Jesus Christ, and I know and I guess it is well with you. A new day, a new dawn, a new promotion for somebody, a new blessing, and somebody there, a turnaround. You are all welcome today in the mighty name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Of course, and indeed, you have been posted with what is going to happen 2015 concerning the our 2 days encounter, destroying evil family pattern. Of course, and indeed, we will get people ready by giving our prayer points ahead of time so that what we do that day is just the conclusion of the matter. Because anything not of God in your family, in your life, will never come to, that day will mark the end. And we are coming in the name above every other name. I'm sure that is the venue. About of the place, and I don't know if people have seen that, but of course the theme of the program is destroying evil family pattern. And God will bless you. Yesterday night, there's somebody there looking at me before we just go into what we will do next. I don't know. You are just looking at me there. There's something. That's why when you do good for people, it turns to become negative. Even when you bless people, even when you intend to do good, it turns out opposite. Yeah, because you have been cursed with a vulture spirit. Yesterday, clearly, I have never seen vulture in the day, but I began to pray about that, that all those who we want to project disgrace, shame, loneliness, affliction, it has ended. And there's somebody there looking at me. That's your sight. You have a sight issue problems now. And you have been taking medication. It's only God. God will deliver you. Take your medication, but you need to pray. And if it is possible, in part of the service tomorrow morning, and because we are going to pray, that you will excel. Because this week is the week of excellence, and it is well. So, by God's grace, but there's one day, the angels of in heaven, one of the angels, I'm sure, he had his third degree from Anambra State. He looked at God and he began to appreciate him, hallow his name, bless his name. And the man sang, and that angel sang a song that manifested in Igbo language. He said that God, you are good. You are the creator of heaven and earth. There's none. You are so nice. Chinekemo. Idima anya neluwa idima okwenkwa meya idima idima nezie idima chinakemo idima anya neluwa idima okwenkwa meya idima idima nezie. Idima, chinakemo, idima, echeto biesike, idima, okwenkwa meya, idima, idima nesye. All right, I'm sure the organist didn't get that very well. Just sing a song. Yes, my sister, sing a song. Girl. Yup, sing a song.
My Lord, yeah.
Yeah.
somebody there looking at me, you have been saying that God has never been good. This week is your week of destiny. Let God deliver you from the powers of sickness, that power of infirmity. There's somebody looking at me. You will never die on in your office. The enemy wants you to die. And you will not die. You will survive and enjoy the fruit of your labor. You are just looking at me. It is well with you. There's somebody there. You saw yourself carrying a coffin. I reject it. You will never bury your children.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
There's somebody, a voice, an evil voice speaking to you. I silence that voice.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
But it is as a result of what you have. You are watching some videos that are deadly. Stop them. Because you are exposing yourself to spiritual attack. All right? God bless you. And there's somebody there. I want you are a man. You look, you will never know any woman. The wife you have, your wife of your youth, the enemy is deceiving you. That your wish and plan, it will not work. Because when it works, you cannot survive 2 years after that. Because you want to deal with somebody that fed you and love you with all her heart. You are looking at me. God is warning you. Be very careful. That which you steal outside may appear better. But it is a normal thing. What you go to steal looks to be better than what you have. It is a normal thing. But be one. All right, but today, what do I have? Of course, and indeed, it's good to get every person ready for next week on Friday. Our usual Pastor Vanna from 9 p.m. Fantastic. And you must be there because we are praying towards the end of... We are going to pray on covenant of exemption. In fact, I will begin it this Sunday service. All those who are coming in, they were entering into the covenant of exemption. Why? The end of the year, people begin to do exchange. All covenants are taking place in the Bible, in the world, all over the world, everywhere in the world. End of the year signifies they want to, as it were, covenants. So that's why we, towards the end of the year, we begin to deal with covenant of exemption, that you are exempted from every demonic, satanic covenant. But if you are part of it, of course, you cannot be exempted. But all we do know, you cannot use the innocent ones in order to initiate any person or to do or to exercise the power of exchange. But today, what do I have? Now, good. We began a teaching this week, and that teaching, please, I want people to call in and disagree, or rather, contribute. I began a study, and this exposition came to me on Monday. It is a study everybody knows. The 10th commandment. And because I was doing a study on how God should magnify. Last week, I taught on when God will begin to magnify you. But God spoke to Joshua. He said, Joshua, my son, from Joshua 3:7-8, that this book of the law shall not depart out of your mouth. You shall meditate on it. And the book of the law, the ridges, the finality of the book of the law is based on the commandments of God. And those, the commandments, the law, the 10 commandments is not to deliver people. Mm-mm. Because the 10 commandments came after the Jews had been delivered from the tax masters. And God told them, in your promised land, if you want to excel, is it in your marriage a promised land? Is it academically a promised land? Is it in your new job a promised land? Is it in your relationship a promised land? If you want to excel in whatever you will do from today, you need to take care of this law. And those laws are 10. We call them 10 commandments. But we don't teach them again. Because the New Testament and the Old Testament is anchored on the Ten Commandments. Jesus Christ did not come to cancel Ten Commandments. One, he cannot cancel it. Two, he existed and operated under it. Three, the third commandment was a handwritten law by God himself. God used his hand to write it. He didn't use my hand, his own hand, and he didn't speak through any person, through Moses or through Elijah. Mm-mm. He himself wrote it down. So, and he said, Joshua, therein lies success. I may call you, I may anoint you, I may make you great, but if you don't operate under this law, you cannot excel. And that's why we began that teaching, and it has been a blessing. So we talked about the first commandment, the third commandment, and today we want to talk about the fourth commandment. So if you want to excel in life, you just go and study the Ten Commandments. If you live according to that scripture, that law, you must excel. Satan cannot undo you. The enemy cannot get you. If your hands are clean, if you are fighting, it's very easy to fight. Once your hands are clean, because in law, he that seeks equity must come with a clean hands. So today, we are talking about the fourth law. And it's very interesting. The fourth law is a law that looks simple, but as it were, there have been some controversies. But in the word of God, there's no controversy. It's either you want to deceive yourself or you live in denial. And that is your choice. Please, can you read for me Exodus 20, verse 8, please?
Exodus 20, verse 8.
Yes, sir.
Remember the Sabbath day to keep it holy.
God was saying that the fourth law is that you must remember the Sabbath day to keep it holy. The Sabbath day is the day of rest that God entered. And this law has been existence even before man. I mean, immediately after creation, this law to keep the Sabbath day holy is not a law given to the Jews immediately after they left Egypt. God rested on the seventh day. And so that is the spiritual foundation of this commandment. What is a Sabbath day for me? A Sabbath day is out of the 7 days of the week. Any day of rest. And different religions have taken different days of rest. The key thing is not, is this Saturday? Is this Sunday? Is it Friday? Is it Wednesday? Is it Thursday? For me, the key and the fundamental thing is that out of the 7 days in a week, which one have you hallowed, decided to make it a Sabbath day unto the Lord? In fact, it's good to read for that Exodus. Exodus 20. Read from 8 to 11, please.
Exodus 28 to 11.
Yes.
Remember the Sabbath day to keep it holy.
Uh-huh.
6 days shall thou labor and do all thy work.
Uh-huh.
But the seventh day is the Sabbath of the Lord thy God.
He says, 6 days. Shall you labor? So 6 days. Naina said the seventh day. So out of the 7 days in a week, the 6 day is for you. You is for man. Is for you. Is for still for God. But on the seventh day, as it were, all what you will do have to do much more things that are eternal, spiritual things that have to do. At least you find a quality time to remember and, one, be at rest as a person. So it has physical and spiritual components. One, God rested on that day. He needed to rest, means give yourself some break. Because it means that you need break. Secondly, spiritually, be focused. And remember your relationship and your maker. And the day he created you. And why? What is your role on earth? How have your day been with God all through that week? And you hallow his name, praise his name, worship him, glorify him for that day, taking a day, some hours now. Yes.
He said, in it thou shalt do no work.
He said, do no work.
Thou, nor thy son, nor thy daughter.
Uh-huh.
Thy hands, but thy manservant, nor thy maidservant,
uh-huh.
nor thy cattle, nor the strangers within thy gates.
Exactly. So the key thing about the Sabbath day is that you must, as it were, do no work. But that is where, go to Isaiah 58, please. Isaiah 58, 13 to 14. Isaiah, the book of Isaiah.
Isaiah 58, 13 to 14.
Yes.
If thou turn away thy foot from the Sabbath,
yeah.
from doing thy pleasure on my holy day,
uh-huh.
and call the Sabbath a delight,
yeah.
the holy of the Lord honorable, and shall honor him, not doing thy own ways, not finding thy own pleasure, nor speaking thy own ways, then shalt thou delight thyself in the Lord, and I will cause thee to ride upon the high places of the earth,
uh-huh.
and feed thee with the heritage of Jacob thy father.
Uh-huh.
For the mouth of the Lord has spoken it.
You see, and so God was saying that, you see, for us, the Sabbath day now, is it a Sunday? Is it for some people, Saturday is the Sabbath day? Some people, it's Friday. The key thing is this. He said that if you want to prosper in life, there's a need for you. In order to find a day, you go to church to thank God for your family, for your work, for your life, for your children. You spend some quality time to thank God and praise his name and hallow his name for what he is to you and for what you mean to him. At times I pray, I say, God, I thank you for who you are to me and for what I mean to you. Of course, he took time to create me. Because God has a purpose. So you thank him for the God that delivered you from that sickness, that affliction. The God that kept you in your new job. I mean, yes, the God that kept your children, all your travel, you're running up and down all the week. You fly up and down. Anything can happen. Some take off and they crash and that's it. But you have been flying up and down and God has been there. Some people go to office on their way back. On their own, car can come and smite them. But you are there. You thank God. Some people, your age mate, your schoolmates, some don't even have good health and you have it. You thank God for his little mercy. Some people can't eat. They have the means to eat, but they cannot eat. Or you can eat. You can be happy. There's everything to thank God for. Is it concerning your wife or your children? So yeah, you find a day to hallow him, to thank God. Genesis 31, 13. It was God that began this. It was God himself that rested. Because some people looking at me here, they don't know Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday. They don't know. Or they work until they die. Is it not too much? You don't prosper as a result of your effort, my friend. I'm with you.
Genesis 31:13.
Yes.
I am the Lord God of Bethel.
I am the Lord God of Bethel. Yes.
Where thou anointest the pillar.
Uh-huh.
And where thou vowest a vow unto me.
Uh-huh.
Now arise, get thee out from this land.
Uh-huh.
And return unto the land of thy kindred.
Uh-huh.
I continue.
Yes.
And Rachel and Leah and
okay, that is Genesis.
That, yes.
Go to 31. If there's Genesis 31 there. A verse of it, please.
Verse 31.
Yes.
And Jacob answered and said to Laban,
uh-huh.
because I was afraid, and I said,
okay. Go ahead.
Peradventure.
Yes.
Thou wouldest take by force thy okay. daughters from me.
Okay, no. Well, there's a scripture this morning. In fact, oh my Holy Spirit, thank you, Holy Spirit. Go to Genesis chapter 2. And read from 2 to 3, please. Genesis 2, 2 to 3. Yeah, that is the scripture. Yes, I'm with you.
Genesis 2 from verse 2.
Yeah.
And on the seventh day.
And on the seventh day.
God was, ended his work.
God ended his work.
Which he had made.
Look. Uh-huh.
And he rested on the seventh day.
And he rested on the seventh day.
From all his work which he had made.
From all his work which he has made.
And God blessed the seventh day.
And God blessed the seventh day.
And sanctified it.
And sanctified it means that he blessed, he not only blessed it, he sanctified it as his own day.
Because in it he had rested from all his work.
So that if you begin to rest and thank God for your Sunday, we Christians, or for you, any day that you choose, or that religion, any day that you choose to say, God, I thank you, you will naturally enter your rest, because it is a command for you to prosper, for you to excel in life. Do you find time to thank God for who he is? Because that day is a day God himself rested. Of course, there have been different interpretations. And that was the problem between Jesus Christ and the Jews. The religious leaders of his time. The Jewish nation interpreted this scripture up to today. That you don't do anything. In fact, I was sharing this, I think, last year. Somebody gave a testimony. Ada would agree, whatever. He was walking on the street. A Jewish lady saw her and called her that my daughter is sick. It was on a Saturday. Please, can you take this phone and call to know how far she is, how well, in the hospital? Then inform me. She gave her her phone and asked her to call the daughter because she's not allowed by religious law to call, to use phone. To enter car, to watch any, nothing, you don't even do anything. That is understanding. So Jesus Christ was so upset with this understanding because he said the law, the Sabbath is for man, not man for the Sabbath. So the Sabbath is not a hindrance. Because it means that you can do good works on a Sabbath day, you are hallowing God. Doctors and nurses who have their job on those days, they are still serving God. There are people who the schedule of their duty, they are fall on a Sunday, Christians or whatever. You are still doing the work of God. Even apart from doctors or nurses, whatever it is, as long as you did not engineer it because of the time and the season that you are in. But you must compensate for that if you are smart. That's why Jesus Christ, go to Matthew. Is it Matthew 12, 1 to 8, please? Matthew 12, 1 to 8. Because Jesus Christ was quarreling with the Jews. He said, this is not what God meant. He didn't mean that, like a lady now that saw a member of Jesus' sanctuary on the highway, I mean on the road, on the street. She cannot use the phone, but she gave her phone to call so that she can speak to her. So what is the difference? What is the difference? How would you?
Matthew 12 from verse 1 to 8.
Yes, sir.
At that time, Jesus went on the Sabbath day through the corn, and the disciples were hungry and began to pluck the ears of corn and to eat. But when the Pharisees saw it, they said unto him, behold, thy disciples do that which is not lawful to do upon the Sabbath day. And he said unto them, have you not read what David did when he was hungry, and they that were with him, how he entered into the house of God, and did eat the shew bread, which was not lawful for him to eat, neither for them which were with him, but only for the priest? Or have you not read in the law how that on the Sabbath days, the priest in the temple profane the Sabbath and are blameless?
Yeah, of course. Today, a rabbi from Israel called me this morning. A rabbi. He called me to apologize over. So I said, no. It's done because I traveled to Israel and something just happened in Israel. He called me that, oh, he's very sorry. No, and I said, no, I'm not offended, of course. He called me on the phone. Because he said that he doesn't have peace. I said, fine. I know. Once I'm upset with you, you can't have peace. Of course. Of course. Of course. Some peace. But so Jesus Christ did healing. He healed somebody. They were saying, how can you do that on a Sabbath day? He said, kill a day. Is it as long as you do good on a Sabbath day. Underline that principle. It's very important. Luke 13, please. Luke chapter 13, then I zero in. Then I begin to bring in into what some people do today in order, and they deceive themselves. Yes?
From what verse?
From 10, please.
Luke 13, from verse 10.
Yes.
And he was teaching in one of the synagogues on the Sabbath.
Uh-huh.
And behold, there was a woman
uh-huh.
which had a spirit of infirmity
uh-huh.
18 years
uh-huh.
and was bowed together
uh-huh.
and could in no wise lift up herself.
Uh-huh.
And when Jesus saw her, he called her to him and said unto her, Woman, thou art loosed
yeah.
from thy infirmity.
Uh-huh.
And he laid his hands on her, and immediately she was made straight and glorified God. And the ruler of the synagogue answered with indignation, because that Jesus had healed on the Sabbath day, and said unto the people, There are 6 days in which men ought to walk. In them therefore come and be healed,
yes.
and not on the Sabbath day. The Lord then answered him and said, Thou hypocrite,
exactly.
doth not each of you on the Sabbath day uh-huh. loose his ox
uh-huh.
or his ass from the stall, and lead him away for watering? And ought not this woman, being a daughter of Abraham, whom Satan had bound, loose these 18 years, be loosed from the bond on the Sabbath day?
I'm okay. What Jesus Christ is saying is that on the Sabbath day, it's good to do good. Good works. Instead of the work of God. But he was in the, he was where? In the synagogue. On the, just like people, like we who are Christians. Sunday, you go to church. Why? Because the Sabbath is not a curse unto us. It's the day you hallow and praise God. Assuming you are driving to the church and you have, and you see somebody, okay, the engineer in the studio, Uche was coming to church on Sunday. A lady gave testimony. Uche, the engineer, is a member of Jesus Sanctuary. You cannot relate with me and be the same. Of course. Of course. Because he has related with me for 6 years. For 6 years. Or 7 years now. And God has never used him. So today he's a member. In fact, he married from Jesus Sanctuary. Dividend. So that's why I've told him that we have settled you here on earth. So you better begin to find a way. And she too, and she married the best in the church. I'm telling you. But he was coming to church. And behold, a lady was bleeding. She didn't know her. But actually the lady was equally a member of Jesus Sanctuary. And she helped to call ambulance and took her to the hospital. Of course, before they will finish all that, the church about God have seen it. That one is even much more work than even preaching. Because the Sabbath is not a curse unto man. Mark 2:27, sir. Mark 2:27.
Mark 2:27.
Yes. Yes.
And he said unto them,
yes.
The Sabbath was made for man.
He said the Sabbath, Jesus Christ was telling the Jewish leaders, the Sabbath was made for man.
And not man for the Sabbath.
And not man for the Sabbath. So the Sabbath cannot be a curse unto us. So that you can be free and do good. But the important thing is that you must find a day of rest where you remember God and praise his name. Out of the 7 days. For we Christians, Sunday is that day. And that is where I conclude this message. How many of us do go to church? Oh, the churches are now useless. But of course, but you watch and stay at home and begin to watch all the video, all the pornographic films and video. Some of you. And you're saying that the churches are useless. Of course. Some people will prefer to miss church in order to watch football. I'm not against football. I watch it, my brother. I even record at times if I'm not, if it don't. I watch. Today, I was almost late there because of I was watching. I wanted to, I was studying and watching how Federer was defeated. Yesterday, I was so by Murphy. I was so happy because I like underdogs winning this name, you know. So I was enjoying it, but I was studying, you know. That's why I wrote Matthew 13, and Holy Spirit just told me that is Matthew 2, you want to. I'm telling you, but I was watching, but I was enjoying it. So that is not sin. But when you now abandon on a Sunday, some of you go to office and choose weekend work because there's more pay. You say, God will understand. You will, if of course, once in a week or twice in a month, your schedule falling on a Sunday, that we are in, God understands that. But for you to make sure, some people work hard to make sure they work weekend, double pay, because Satan wants you to not to succeed. He knows it's a law of God, a powerful law. Tomorrow now, some people will sit down at home doing nothing, lousing about, and go to dance all the parties at night on Saturday. This Saturday now, they go on the Friday night, you boogie down. Saturday night, you boogie down. Then Sunday, you just relax and you be at the park by 4 o'clock in the evening. Is that passenger? And that's why I don't pray for no person on Sunday. Because those who don't go to church are those who call you on Sunday. Because if you go to church, a word must come from the pulpit. If you are going to a true church, a word must come from the pulpit to handle your case. Because all this call me for prayer, call me for that, call me for prayer. I open the line for people to contribute. Some do pray for me and some ask for prayer. I can understand that. But not when you see your people. You call me, I'm waiting. The callers are waiting. If you have power, you don't ask people to call you for prayer. Any prayer that you pray, it removes, gets virtue out of you. It draws it. And you don't know who you are praying for. That is key. I'm not saying it's not good to pray for people. But many of you who sit down at home, Sunday they go and do jogging. At times I see my brothers, they will do jogging. Because people born in the Western world are doing jogging. When your mother sold property before you cross the sea, you are looking at me. Your mother sold all they have to sell it. Instead of you to come here and work hard and exist and try to lift up yourself beyond the level and go home and settle. Because you must work to know that you will not die here. Whether you like it or not, it is a curse. You must work and go home and enter your rest and be a factor in your home. That you come here and because I am a citizen. After us, you are running. You see the hour at times I see here, yes, running on Sunday. Man, you are looking at me there. I'm talking to you. But if you go to church, but some churches too and indulge us, they do 1 hour service. 1 hour. 30 minutes service. 30 minutes. 30 minutes. You say church do 5 services in a week. 5. If not for space, I would do 2. In space, if I have the enough space to take 800 people, 600, 800 people, finish. I won't do one service. 1. Because it is a strain on you. But some of you, you just sit down and deceive yourself all throughout the week. How can you prosper? When a Muslim goes to mosque almost every day and prays 5 times a day, a Jewish person goes to synagogue and they follow it religiously. How can they not prosper? Check out. Check yourself. Assess how many hours you spend on your internet, on your iPad, on your phone, on all those useless things. Then how many times do you spend on your God? 10 minutes. I soak myself in the blood. Then you, no. What am I trying to tell you? Spend some quality time in the presence of God so that you can be blessed. And you rest too. And do some reflection. Ask some questions about your life. Why are things like that in your family? Why are you not what you are supposed to be? The Spirit of God can minister to you. And you study the Bible and you grow thereby. And that is my prayer. Let God make each and every one of us, as we study this Bible, including me, my Father, my Holy Spirit, will draw us closer and nearer. In Jesus' name, I pray. Draw me nearer, Lord. Draw me nearer, nearer to thee. Oh yes, my songs every day. Father, draw me nearer. Ewo. Draw me nearer, nearer to thee. Oh yes, my songs every day. Ewo. Father, draw me closer. Ewo. Draw me nearer, nearer. There's this song I love when I was quite a child, a lad. Each time I go to Catholic church, then I love it. Obasakaya nobe. Obasakaya nobe. Obasakaya nobe. Sionye chorondu. He said that Jesus' hand is on the cross, inviting each and every one of you. And that is my invitation this morning. First time, okay. Jonathan from London is on the line. How are you, sir?
Good afternoon, sir.
Yes, sir. I'm with you, sir.
Yes, sir. I enjoy your teaching this afternoon.
Thank you, sir.
Not only this afternoon, every day I make a time to watch you, and I find out that you are leading people to the right track. And you preach the truth. And I'm happy that you have been teaching about the law, which guides everybody.
Yes.
But this afternoon,
yes,
there is a question because I'm confused.
Please.
There's something I want you to clear.
Please.
You, God started work probably on Thursday and rested on 7 days.
Yes.
Which you have mentioned.
Yes.
I truly want to know which particular day is that 7 day. Publicly,
exactly.
That we have to follow. And which day is the first day?
Exactly.
Thank you, that's my question.
Okay, my brother, it's a very legitimate question. But I have this, you know, like now, China is sleeping or somewhere. Japan is awake. So that you can see that all the nations, there is not one, the day, as it were, but for me, I follow the Bible. The Bible makes it clear that the beginning of the day, at times, is that's why they said in the beginning, and the day and the night was in the morning. So what you are saying is very right. But for me, what I take more, if you take one day out of the 7 day and make it your own day, and that's why I began by taking going up front with that question. That any day that you choose. Some people can eat. It must not be because nobody. It must not be that particular day, because a day before the Lord is like 1,000 years, and 1,000 years before God, that is the Bible, is like a day. So what we try to do is to take one day. Somebody can take a Friday, the Muslim side Friday. There's nothing wrong about that. The Jewish people have Saturday. There's nothing wrong about that. We Christians have Sunday. There's nothing wrong about that. Somebody can take even a Monday. As long as you hallow that day, that is the key thing. But I don't know if I answered you well, but that is the only answer I know. I'm sure somebody may be better in a better position, but I'm not into logical or physiological. I go for the key thing. What is not like Christmas Day? People say Jesus Christ was not born on a Christmas Day. It's not important. The important thing is that day was the day he said he was born. Fine. And that's it. That is for me. All right. I hope I answered. If not, sir, it is well. And you can email me and we'll talk more on that just because of time. I hope I did well. If not, score me 0/100. The Lord knows I'm saying to the extent that I do know. I don't know anything at all. It's the little one I know I'm sharing. Okay, Caddy from London. How are you, sir?
Good afternoon, sir. man. Thank you, sir.
Oh, sorry, madam. I'm very sorry. Is that okay, Kadi?
Okay, sir.
Yes, I'm with you. I'm with you.
With this program. The day you started the first, the 10 commandments.
Yes.
I took the first one and prayed. And I woke up with the dream that you said about the vulture. I prayed to the vulture, and the vulture wanted to stand in front of me. I said, with the blood of Jesus, I will finish you today.
Amen.
That prayer that you said, it was for me, and thank you for educating me. Amen. God will bless you and your family.
Amen.
Thank you. That's all I have to say. If people follow your word, they will get where they want to get to.
Amen.
Because everybody have their intention in life. But thank you for educating us.
Thank you.
God will prosper you.
Amen.
And God will make your pockets to full for this program to continue.
Amen.
And you will lead us in the righteous way.
Amen.
Jesus' name I pray.
Amen.
Amen. Thank you, sir.
Look, you have given me £1 million now by that prayer to lead people on the righteous way. Because it is better I die today, than to mislead people. I should get out in Jesus' name. Than to mislead people. That is my prayer always in Jesus' name. Thank you so much, man. Okay, Ola from London. How are you, sir?
I'm fine.
I'm sorry. Ola, how are you, man? I'm very sorry. I'm with you, man. I'm with you.
Me, I'm with you.
No, reduce the volume of your TV set, man. If not, we can't hear you at all. We can't hear you, and the time is running. I'm with you, man.
Okay, I need prayer for God to just help me.
Just help you. Well, okay, but do you know this God that you're asking to help you? Huh?
I know him very well, though.
Very well.
Very, very well.
Okay. How do you know him? Very well. Yes. I'm with you.
He's the God of the suddenly. He's the unchanging changer. He's the Alpha and the Omega.
Amen.
He's the I am that I am.
Look, you are. I like you. I like this lady. Okay, let me just pray for you. But let me just, I will ask you to ask something. Because they will ask the Jesus that touched me to touch you. And you will notice a difference. If you do it, that the Jesus that touched this man now, that you're seeing, this pastor, that let that Jesus touch you. Just you and you alone. You will notice something great. Something will begin to happen in your life. It happened to me. Let me pray for you, as you said, anyhow. Let the Jesus that touched me touch you. He knows your heart. He has seen your sincerity. So that he will reveal himself to you. So that you will walk on the path of righteousness. And you will eat the fruit of your labor, my dear. And you will never vegetate. And that is my prayer. In Jesus' name. All right. There's another caller. Lawrence from Italy. Hello.
God bless you, sir.
Yes, I'm with you, sir.
Sir, I want to ask you a question concerning your teaching.
Yes. Please.
About Sabbath day.
Yes.
But do you think give me sleepless night or this? Yeah, my mind was telling me if the book of Exodus chapter 20, verse 8 talk about Sabbath day, God created a work for good 6 days, 7 days he rested, which is the Saturday. My mind was telling me it's supposed to be Saturday instead of Sunday worshiping God. So I wanted to throw more light to that. Number two question, sir. Why are we celebrating Christmas on the 25th of December? Because there is no specific date that Jesus Christ was being born on the 25th of December.
You are absolutely right in your questions, but you didn't hear my submission. And that's why you're asking that question. And that's why I began by saying that I'm not into which one is the Sabbath day. But the key thing is this. He rested on the seventh day. Seventh. So any seventh day the Christians have taken Sunday, so be it. The Muslims have taken Friday. So be it. the Jews are taking Saturday, so be it. So why not take one date and so be it, so that we leave vain disputation. According to Paul says that he doesn't go into unprofitable thing. Is that like people saying that who actually created God that created God? All this is, you just have headache and sleepless night. Leave who created God and follow whom your spirit, the Jesus, because there are so many things you cannot even know about your life, about your foundation. Why were you born in Cameroon or in Kafanchan or in America or in China? Why were we not all born in Israel? Those things are vain disputation. The major thing is that whether Jesus Christ was born on 25th, that's why I said the Christians take 25th on Christmas Day. One thing I do is that unless 25th falls on a Sunday, I said I'll go. If it falls on any day, I don't do service. But the important thing, I will eat rice and chicken in remembrance of the birth of Jesus Christ. Chicken with garnished. In fact, I'm waiting for the next Christmas. The major thing, that will not take me to heaven. What will take me to heaven is your relationship with God. And if you are obedient with the 10 commandments of God. Simple. Oh, my brother. Loro, leave that one. No. Follow the will. And God bless you, sir. It's where we do. Okay, Amaka from Bradford. How are you, ma? Hello, Amaka.
Yeah, good afternoon, sir.
I'm with you.
Okay. Daddy.
No, Pastor. Pastor.
Life and,
Amen. Amen.
I follow your preaching. Even yes. Today, I just missed it by. I thought it was 4 o'clock. I forgot it was 3 o'clock.
Oh, no.
I just wanted to pray for my family, for God's restoration, and my father-in-law that is sick.
No, I use as a point of contact for restoration for families and our parents, our mothers, our beloved ones, who are even children that are sick. Only God can heal through his son, our Lord Jesus Christ. The Jesus that healed in the Bible is still in the business of healing after today. And that is my prayer. Let there be visitation into every home under the flood of my voice in Jesus' name. All right. Chinedu from London. How are you, Chinedu?
I'm very fine, sir. You are blessed, and you will continue to be blessed by the grace of God in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Please, the last two callers.
Yes.
Please, I want to advise all that do call to please, this is a quality time, and a lot of money is being spent to be on air. Instead of coming to argue and coming to distract people by the phone calls, please give a quality contribution. Please, because the pastor did mention about this day. You can provide a day and make it a day of worshipping God, a day of holiness, Halloween God.
Exactly.
So I don't see why some people who should now jump in and start to argue on the phone,
yes,
while others are cleaning up.
Yes.
So, Pastor, please, I want to encourage you and your ministry and your family.
Yes.
Keep doing what you are doing. And we are lifting you, my family, we are lifting you before the presence of God.
Yeah.
And I know other families are doing likewise.
Yeah.
And you will go places.
Thank you.
The most important thing is our salvation. Salvation.
Yeah, exactly.
That is the key. And that is what God has sent you to do here.
Amen. Amen.
And I pray that God will strengthen you,
amen,
empower you, and give you the resources.
Amen.
And also give you the money.
Amen.
Because money is needed in the ministry.
Yeah.
God will empower you with money, materialism, to move forward the ministry of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen. Thank you so
much. Amen.
No, I say amen 3 times. Amen, amen, amen. I love that. But like you slightly said, but again, too, such questions to add equally value makes the program interesting. Because at times, too, some people, but people have different understanding. And that is the essence of the. I'm sure, too, they have learned. But you have contributed effectively, as always, sir. Thanks a lot. Solomon from Dustem, is it? I'm seeing some name. Is that Solomon?
Yeah, Solomon.
Yeah, how are you, sir?
Yes, yes.
Where are you calling from?
I'm fine, sir. Very.
Where are you
calling from? From Dunstable.
Okay, Dunstable. Ah.
Dunstable.
Ah, I've never heard that name. I'm with you.
It's just before Luton. It's just in Luton.
Ah, that's good.
Yeah, thanks so much. I'm very, very happy to get through today, Pastor. And your program is a rich source of encouragement for the family. Hello?
Yes, I'm with you.
Yeah, we just want you to pray for me and my family, sir. We're going through some financial issues right now, and also immigration from...
Don't stand low. I know what it is. All you need to do, if I were you, I'm sure probably you have done it. Make commitment to God. Bring him in. Commit yourself. Make a vow. Father, look, do this for me. But because God is, you know, challenges comes in life, you will still overcome. And that's why the Bible says it came to pass. And your own case will be like that in Jesus' name. Just relax. Your purpose will come. All right? Juliet from Italy, how are you? And the last caller, I guess. I'm with you. Juliet, are you there? All right, look, because of time, look, like I said, tomorrow, please, those of us traveling, if you know you are traveling, and we are going to do a program tomorrow, but for covenant of exemption, powerful, because I get ready, but I'm going to do that little teaching as soon as I'm done with this laws of God, because by Wednesday, I will begin the 5th, the 6th, the 7th, that of adultery, that of all those things will help you and help me. Let God keep you and prosper you in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Let God hear your cry. There's somebody there, God will showcase you himself. You are looking at me. God himself will showcase you. Of course, for those of you who want to attend our morning service from 9 a.m. to 11:30 and from 12 noon to 2 p.m., and you will be blessed, especially, please, covenant of exemption towards the end of the year. Next week is our all night, and we will pray about the new year. 2015 will announce somebody there. Your greatness, barrenness have ended in your family, in your life. You are looking at me. Barrenness in any shape and form. Let God keep you and prosper you. I got to leave, but the Lord is your shepherd. He will keep you. You shall not want. He made you to lie down in green pastures. He leaded you beside the still waters. He restored your soul. He leaded in the path of righteousness for his namesake. Yea, though you may walk through the valley of the shadow of death, you shall fear no evil. Because the Lord is your Father. I have a Father, Almighty Father, Ewa, King of Kings, Lord of Lords. I have a Father.
Hear you say.